Hello Chemo friends and welcome to this new video. So I am finally been able to shoot a video which showcases the beautiful Black Fencer Montante which was sent me the past month. Just in case, if you are asking yourself, don't worry, the review will come soon. But anyway, if you have already fallen in love with this beautiful beast and you want to know more, check the Black Fencer link in the video description. Okay, so I am lesser experienced in Montante handling compared to my experience in medieval weapons, so I decided to bring you into my step-by-step learning process. My friend Niccolo Menozzi, which is a Spadone nerd, shared me this rather short and relatively simple to read Spanish source, Las Nueve Reglas de la Espada de Dos Manos, dated around 1526. A tiny manual featuring 9 progressive solo drills, starting from the basic movements and creating more complex actions. So today we are going to learn together the first 3 reglas, the basic ones. So without further chats, let's start. The first regla works this way. Mutante entering with the right leg, fast mutante entering with the left leg, as many times as you like, forward and turn back. Okay, the first regla is simple, it's all about upward cuts. Mutante is the right one. Fast mutante simply means left mutante. The source don't specify 2-edge or false edge ones. So personally, I will go for both the options. The source uses the term entrando when it talks about full steps. So here we go with full steps only, moving forward. I personally found the 2-edge one easier to execute, as the coordination between legs and arms is closer to the one of the longsword. The false-edge one is just a tiny bit more complex to execute at the beginning in these terms. Besides that, it's kind of a straightforward rule. So let's jump into the second one. The second rule is mandrete entering with the right leg, revés entering with the left leg, as many times as you like, forward and back. So here we go with our downward cut. Mandrete is what in many other sources is simply called tejo, which means cut. Here we have a Spanish version of the word mandrito, which means from the right. So mandrete is our right cut. Instead, the revés is the reverso, the cut from the left. Besides that, the rule is pretty similar to the first one, mandrete with a full step, and the revés with another full step. In the end of this second rule, we find specified forward and back. It's hard to understand if it refers to moving both forward and backward while landing the cuts, or either just turning backward and keep going with the exercise, as it is specified in the first rule. Anyway, I just decided to train every cutting action both forward and backward, which is anyway a reasonable idea, be it what the source says or not. I just said that mandrete and revés are downward cuts, but the reality is that they should probably be considered everything above the horizontal line. With a long weapon as the montante, doing proper downward cuts without touching the ground is kind of hard. Yes, you can always stop your weapon before it reaches it, but believe me, it's slightly harder to stop a montante compared to a longsword, so better taking lesser steep path to facilitate our work. Very good, second rule done, let's go with the third one. The third rule is thrust entering with the right leg and thrust entering with the left leg as many times as you like. Again, simple and straightforward. The only question which we should ask ourselves is which kind of thrust? Well, personally speaking, I suppose we should train both high and low thrust. The rule to me leaves us free of specific terms simply because every form should be trained, so specifying is irrelevant. So the source doesn't present guards or starting position to start our actions. I personally felt comfortable in starting my low thrust from a flug-like kind of guard. I just felt it was the best option while trying out different starting positions. The hard part while training low thrusts is, again, coordination. I wanted to keep the weapon extended till the very last split of second of my foot advance, which is a reasonable thing to do while thrusting with any weapon, but this ties a lot of the arms, so this aspect needs to be balanced in some way. The high thrust is instead quite easier. I inverted the footwork pattern while executing it. Right thrust while moving forward the left foot, left thrust while moving the right foot. It just feels more comfortable. And by the way, funny enough, is still in line with the source itself. Very good, our first Montante training is done. If you want to try it too, just be sure of warming up properly before training. This weapon is not forgiving on many aspects. And remember people, if you want to help me grow up this channel, check my Patreon page link in the video description. Our new Discord server with a growing friendly HEMA community awaits you there, together with many exclusive videos and articles. Thanks for watching people, and as always, see you next time.